Hi guys, in this video I'll teach you how to read and write from Excel files using Python. Let's move to an example. We have this Excel sheet. Okay, it contains many columns and many rows. We will write a small program to make some manipulation on this data and read from it and write to the same file or to another Excel file. First, we will open Jupyter Notebook. Write cmd here to open cmd in this directory. We will write the command to open Jupyter Notebook. Even Jupyter Notebook like this, and if it gave you an error, you can try this python-m notebook, whatever works for you. We will make a new Python 3 file. First, we will import two libraries, the tools that we will use. First we import xlrd. If we don't have xlrd installed in our machine, first we install it using cmd pip install xlrd. Okay, but I already installed it. Okay, the second library we'll use, openpyxl. From this library we'll import load workbook. Okay, and also if you don't have openpyxl, you have to pip install it. Install openpyxl, but I already have it. I already installed it. Okay, we will run this using shift and enter. Okay, we imported these two libraries. Okay, we are ready. After this, we write our code. We will create a workbook to read from the file and another workbook to write to the file. Okay, first the workbook to read from the file, workbook equals xlrd, the library for reading the file. This is to read the file. Okay. Dot open workbook, and we will write the name of the Excel sheet or the Excel workbook, this one. Okay, dot xlsx. Right. Okay, next we will open the sheet that contains the data that we want. Okay, in this file we have the data we want in this sheet, the first sheet. This is the first sheet, the second sheet, the third sheet. We will use this first sheet. Okay, the first sheet will have the index 0. The second sheet will have the index 1, third has the index 2, and so on. Okay, so we'll use the index 0 or the first sheet. We'll create a variable for this, for the first sheet, sheet 1 equal wv, which is this name, the name of the workbook, dot sheet underscore by underscore index, and we'll use the index 0. For the first sheet. Okay, after running this just these two lines of code, we will have now this sheet to contain all the data that we want to read. Okay, for example, if we want to read for example this cell in the fifth row. Okay, not specified, fifth row and the second column. How to read the cell in the fifth row and second column? By using the function cell underscore value. Okay, sheet one, which is this name, the sheet that we want to read from, dot cell underscore value.
This function takes two parameters.
The first parameter is the row index and the second parameter is the column index. The row index here into the fifth row So it will have the index 4 because we start from 0. The first row has index 0, second row 1, 2, 3, 4. So we'll use 4 and 1 for the column because the first column has 0 index and the second column has 1 index. Okay, so we'll open the cell in the 4 and 1. Okay, so we'll write 4 and 1. If we run this, not specified. So this line of code has successfully read this value in this cell.
Okay, we are able now to read anything from this Excel sheet. Of course, we can store this value in a variable var1, for example, equal this value, and then print it or use it wherever in our code. Okay, now we'll try to write to an Excel sheet. Now I'll show you how to write to an existing Excel file or a new Excel file. We'll try to write something in this Excel file, but in the second sheet, for example. Okay, for example, I want to write something here in the second row and the third column. How to do this? First, we have to open the Excel workbook using the function that we imported, load workbook. Let's call it wb2 workbook2 load underscore workbook and write the file name that we want to open to write into it. Okay, we want to try to the same file. We can type any other file if we want. We can create a new file and then write anything to it normally, no problem with that. Next, we'll get the sheet that we want. We want what we want is the second sheet to write into it. How to do this? First, we retrieve all the sheet's names using the function sheet names. Okay, and this function simply take this workbook and retrieve all the sheet names for it and return a list. We want the second one returns. How to do this? Simply we can call it, for example, sheet 1 with s uppercase equal workbook 2, which is this workbook of sheets of 1. Why is that? We want to open the second sheet of this workbook. The sheet name is now stored in this list. We want the second element in the list. We know that from Python that the second element in the list is index 1 and the first one is 0, of course. So we want the second sheet. We write here sheets of 1. So sheets of 1 will return this sheet.
Now we can write in the second sheet of this Excel workbook.
If on the first sheet, of course, we can write 0. Okay, but we want the second one. Okay, how to write anything in this Excel sheet? We will write the sheet name sheet 1 dot cell, and the function cell takes two parameters, the row number and the column number that we want to write. Note that the row number here is the actual row number starting from 1, not the index starting from 0. So if we want to write in the second row and the third column, we will write 2 and 3. The row number is 2 and the column number is 3. Okay, then we'll write dot value and equal to whatever we want to write. Okay, for example, we'll write hello friends. Okay, the last step after writing all whatever you want is to save what we did to this file or to a new file. Okay, we can save it to the same file wb2.save and write the file name, or we can type here any other name. It will save it to a new file. Let's try to use another name, a new file. We will call it output.xlsx. Okay, if we run this lines of code, let's see what will happen. Okay, successfully, no errors. We notice here that there is a new file has been created, the same like the other file that we opened, but we have
here in the second row and third column of the second sheet, hello friends, that we wrote here. Okay, now we know how to read and write in Excel sheets. We can use this method to automate our work and do so many things useful. So that's all for this video. If you want me to make another video to show you some application, some useful application in Python, we can use it to make this method useful. Or if you face any problem or you have any question, please leave me a comment. Don't forget like and subscribe. Thank you and goodbye.